This is the hardware CV instrument device, new to Bitwig Studio 2.0. It's very easy to use in order to tune and control CV-based analog synthesizers. You simply select the output, which is connected to the volt octave pitch input on your analog synthesizer. In my case, it's output number one on a Expert Sleeper's ES3 module. And the gate output goes to the gate input on your analog synthesizer. In my case, I have output two connected to my Make Noise Zero Coast. And the volt octave output is going into the attenuator on the Zero Coast and then into the volt octave input. And I use the attenuator because the output voltage range on the ES3 is very wide, and it just makes it a little bit easier to get things in tune. But you also need to have the output of the synthesizer connected to the audio input on the hardware CV instrument device so that it can track the pitch of the input and calibrate it. And with all of that done, I simply click the tune button and it will go through the voltage range and detect pitches. And now when I play my sequence, everything will be in tune. I also have the option to add other CV devices and send them to other outputs on the ES3 to my Make Noise Zero Coast. I have a random modulation generator connected to the multiply input, as well as an LFO. These modulation signals are being sent to output number three on my ES3. I can add another CV out module. Send that signal to output number four. Set it to unipolar because the overtone parameter is set all the way down, and we're only working with positive voltages here. Everybody likes delay. Add some depth to the patch. And this Memory Man delay has a expression pedal input. I can even send CV input to that. Here I'm controlling the delay time directly from Bitwig using a hardware CV output device. And can go ahead and modulate that as well. Thank you. going to demonstrate the hardware CV input modulator in Bitwig Studio 2.0. I have a number of hardware CV input modulators already set up to control Madrona Labs Alto here. I can create a new modulator by selecting it from the list in Bitwig Studio. Right now, you don't hear any sound, but I can route this envelope, this self-cycling envelope from Make Noise Mats to the fifth input on my Expert Sleeper's ES6. So I can select that input in the hardware CV device and then route the signal to the main output in Alto. So now the envelope is controlling the output level. You can see that other aspects of the patch are also controlling the synth. My woggle bug is being clocked by the self-cycling channel of maths and is then modulating the oscillator index and ratio, as well as the envelope repeat or envelope 2. I have a qubit nano rand, which is modulating also the oscillator ratio and the amount of signal going to the reverb. I like the hardware CV input because it allows me to bring modulation sources from my hardware and use them to control software. It responds very much like my hardware modular would. It responds nicely to fast modulation. You know, it allows me to do some things that I have trouble doing with software alone. I can add modulators to synths that only have a few, and process control voltages in interesting ways. Just another neat feature of Bitwig 2.0. Using the hardware clock out device new to Bitwig Studio 2.0 to control my analog modular synthesizer. I have the main clock output routed to the output number 1 on the ES3 from Expert Sleepers, and that is going into the clock input on my 4MS rotating clock divider. The first output on the rotating clock divider is then routed to the IntelliGel U-Step and Make Noise Brains with pressure points combination. The reset output is then distributed to the rotating clock divider, the U-Step, and Brains. The nice thing about the clock device in Bitwig is that you can use the numerator for the reset output to change the length of the sequence that you're working with. So originally I had it at 8 steps, now it's at 7. I can
reduce it to any length that I want, and allows some variation in the sequences that I create. It's also a lot of fun to modulate the rate of the sequence to get interesting variations. Here I will introduce some modulation to the